Okay, this is how we set up the Flotrak for the EV1000. You have to have an art line for the Flotrak part. The Flotrak is the top piece here for the EV1000. So the only thing we're really going to start doing here is change the tubing. Okay, so you have to have the Flotrak tubing. Open it up. It looks like this. This is really just arterial line tubing. Okay, one side that goes to your pressure bag, and then the other side that goes to your patient. And this is your inline, your vamp for your blood, right? So it's the same thing as the syringe that you pull back, except this just looks a little bit different. And this is the side that you connect to your patient. So you would spike this, you would pump up your pressure bag and prime your tubing until it gets to the end. Step number one, okay? Thing that's different about this is your transducer and this is the connector, right? So these are different because this is what is compatible with the Flotrak. So this is really pretty easy. I turn the machine on, okay? Connectors, you have to make sure that you're using the connectors for the Flotrak part if you're doing the Flotrak with the A-line. This bottom piece is the ClearSight. So that's the one that goes on the finger cuff. That's a totally different thing. So if you're, it's either one or the other. So if you're not using the finger cuff, don't touch anything here or down, okay? You want this cord because this is the Flotrak.
Can I also add something?
Yes.
Just because the last time someone tried to use the EV1000, they were using this wrong cord.
And had it plugged in here.
Oh, you already showed. Yeah, it will plug into this.
Yeah.
This is the old cord for the old Flotrak. So if you have the single one by itself, it will not work.
Yeah.
If you plug it in, you have to use the triple cord.
Yes. And these are CVP cords. We don't use these. They're there. It's an option. But there's nothing going to be plugged into these, okay? You use the triple cord and you have to plug the green one into the green side. It's just like your other A-line cords, except this one's round instead of square. It plugs right in there. Okay. Then we also have this side. Okay. This thingy is for your art line to go to the monitor. So you, because you're going to get information sent to the EV1000, and then you want to also be able to see your A-line tracing to the monitor. The cord is slightly different. This is not the same cord as your normal A-line cord. This one is round. So this end is the same. This end is the round one that fits into this. So you've got to find that cord, plug that in there, and plug this into your monitor. So now we're sending the information to two different places. Next thing, you just got to put in some kind of a patient ID, whatever. I don't think it really matters because we're not sending this information into Epic or anything anyway. We're just looking at it. We do need to put in the height and weight. Because it's going to do cardiac calculations based on the patient's height and weight. So inches, 5'9", will do me 170 pounds. You can do pounds or kilos by clicking the button up there. Age, gender, and then hit home. It's going to take you into the zero waveform screen. And then all you have to do then is go back to your transducer, open your transducer up to air, and then you can zero it on the bedside monitor, and then you can hit zero here just by hitting the zero button. It says zero complete. Open your transducer back up, hit the screen, the home button, and now you should be getting your values here. Okay. So. Nice, this one turned on and it's already all set up for the four parameters that we really would like to see, which are cardiac output and index, the stroke volume, and the SVI. You can change the parameters by clicking the second button here. Along the left side, how many parameters do you want to be able to see? We always want to see four, right? So make sure you have four selected. And then the screens in the middle just show you what your cockpit's going to look like, basically. Like, how do you want the information to be presented? I really like this particular view because it's got the gauges on it, so it kind of shows you if you're like green, yellow, red, if you're in a good place or not in a good place. And if you need to change the parameters, you just click in the individual boxes and you can change it to something different. Okay. Questions about the Flotrak part? That's it. No mystery here. Now, if you forget, there's also laminated instructions with pictures and everything right here connected to the machine as well. Okay. Step by step, very, very clear instructions.
Can you update weights on it?
Can you update weight? Well, that's a great question. Patient data in the settings, and you can change the weight. Yeah. You can even do new patient. The other thing that you can do is, if you want to do it with the finger cuff, do you guys want to talk about that? Because it's possible the doctor may ask you to set that up as well. First of all, when you turn it on, you saw it says Flotrak here at the bottom. If we want to do it with the ClearSight, we have to hit the Flotrak and change it to ClearSight. And then you're going to hit the enter button to continue. It's going to say, are you sure we can switch one time? Yes, I want to switch. I'm going to hit continue. So now, again, if you forget this, there's a guide here, and I always have to look at this because it's not, this part's a little bit not as user-friendly or what we're used to doing as the other. So the cuffs are kept in the supply room. They're on that metal rack, again, between kind of by the linen cart on the other side, in this tiny little bin, like on the maybe second shelf down, okay? You're supposed to measure the finger and put the size of cuff that fits between these two knuckles, the first knuckle and the second. We only have one size of cuff right now because they're super expensive. I think it's like $500 a cuff or something. It's ridiculous. So Janine didn't order three different sizes. She only ordered the medium. She told me she put in an order for the three sizes and they called her from purchasing and said, that's going to be $50,000. Are you sure you want to do that? And she said, no, scratch that. So you have to align the cuff. You have to put it on between the two knuckles. You wrap it around, and it's just like a big little baby blood pressure cuff that goes on the finger, and that's actually where you get your information from. Back on the monitor screen, when you turn it on, it's going to have you enter the height, weight, gender, and age. You press home. Now here's where we diverge from how we set up the Flotrak. You're going to have to zero these two pieces together. This seems very odd, but it's marked on here. There's a line that says zero and zero. You don't have to hold it in any particular place. You just have to make sure that these are at the same level, and then you hit the zero button. Ding, zero, done, okay? Then you have to connect the cuff. This part clips onto the patient's the pocket of their gown. Thank you, my brain's not working. And this part connects to the finger cuff itself, and then the finger cuff will have cords that connect into these slots here as well. Okay, it's Archo's cuff number one or cuff number two. If you're for some reason using two, I don't know why. And then that's pretty much it with that part, except. So you should start to get numbers up here once you hit the start button. Except, it's the strangest thing, but again, recalling right that when we're using ClearSight, you're only putting things down here. If you connect this same red cord that we used for the Flotrak, instead of connecting it into the A line, you're gonna connect this right into here, and then connect the other side to your monitor, and then add that cuff. It's gonna inflate and deflate every like 10, 15 seconds, something like that. It will give you an A-line waveform on your monitor and you'll get a continuous blood pressure reading just from that finger cuff. So it's actually kind of cool. But again, it's very expensive, so I would encourage the doctors to just put in an A-line instead of using, unless there's some really good reason why they wanna use this insanely expensive technology. Questions about the ClearSight. Again, if you forget, just check the thing because it's pretty it's pretty easy if you follow it step by step. You'll be able to figure it out.